Bini nyo ang kinsay number one fan ako din. Ako nga sa awa. Number one. Wala nyo lahat. Every Sunday yun na kuap ka. Karoon na gil ko ka doon nga doon. Every Sunday. Number one nga fan ako na. Ang number one inimin ako din. Ang kinsay nyo. Sila lang. Joke lang. Mayong hapon sa tanan. Wonderful Sunday. Message that I would like to share is, I hope that it will encourage us to be just this man. Caleb, the man with another spirit. Caleb, the man with another spirit. Now, Caleb was one of the millions, 600,000 ang nasa Bible, pero millions to actually. Some says 2 million. Israel that came out from Egypt, a place in which they were in bondage, slavery, says for more than 400 years, 430 years. Caleb was usasya sa milyon, bilyonis ka mga tao nga nahimong gawasan. And when they were set free, and they were now in the wilderness, as they were in the wilderness, when God tested them, and the testing actually came from them. Because when they are now about to enter the promised land, Canaan, Israel themselves, the tribe, asked to spy out the land. And one of those that were chosen in the 12 tribes is Caleb, together with Joshua. When they were tested, only Caleb and Joshua entered the promised land. Meaning to say that God were not that God had redeemed them from slavery. To be slave is restless. To be slave is that you could not choose your own ability, thinking. You have no freedom of your own. You work. Everything that you do must always come to your master. And when they were free, set free, God intended them to be blessed in the land in which God had promised them, a land flowing with milk and honey. And it was only Caleb and Joshua had the privilege to enjoy God's blessings in redemption. Managit ninyo na. Sila nahimong gawas nun. Sila nahimong gawas nun. Ug ang saad sa Ginoo, di lang kay himong gawas nun. Gisaaran sila, naisulod sila ni atong yuta na saad nga dito sila makaangkon og kapahulaya. Out of those millions, only Caleb was privileged to enter it. One reason, because he was a man with another spirit. A man with another spirit. As I sa kuning gina una-una, it is, you see, when God will bless a person, kana nga klase ka espiritu kanunay ang naan niya itong mga tawhana to. O talagsaon lang, sa Biblia, kung tama sa Biblia, talagsaon lang ang mga tao nga nakaangkon niya ng mga espiritu ha, nga diin niya na ang basihan sa Ginoo sa ilahang pag-abunda o sa panalangin sa Ginoo. Another spirit. Now, tanawa sa Numbers chapter 14. Notice in verse 21. Now, ingani, as now you see, if there be, when we speak about blessing, if there be anyone that is so privileged na dapat panalanginan sa Ginoo, kana ang iyahang mga katawhan. Ang iyagod ng mga katawhan. Now tanawa sa Numbers chapter 14, verse 21. Ngunya, and the Lord said Dinya verse 21. But as truly as I live, nya all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord. Then in verse 20, nya, because all those men which have seen my glory and my miracles which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness and have tempted me now these 10 times and have not hearkened to my voice, then I surely they shall not see the land which I swear unto their fathers, neither shall any of them that provoke me see it. In these particular passages, God made a very strong declaration that every man, after which this happened, shall see the glory of God. What are this glory? Anything that you see in this palibot, kung sahay gani, hindi pa mo kontento na ini, muadto pa mo ato mga dapit nga ginabantog ng mga manindot ng mga dapit. Now, when we speak about the glory of God, oftentimes it refers to those visible things that we see in this world. That in effect, you will wonder and you will be amazed. Kanunay na makita sa mga drone, sa mga lapit. Those are the creation of God. Di niya makita nila ang himaya sa Ginoo through His creation. Then, yun niya tanan makakita. And this privilege, this promise that God had given to every man niya, nakita ni sa Israel. Not only that Israel had seen the glory of God through His creation and His power, but likewise, they experienced the miracles and wonders of God. Na-experience siya, so that if there be a nation that was so privileged in the earth in that time, and even this time, it was Israel. But the sad truth is that despite all this glory that they see and the miracles that they had seen and experienced, kini wala ni nakahatag kanila og dugang pagsalig og paghimaya sa Ginoo. In fact, they tested God. 10 times nga ilang gisulay-sulayan ng Ginoo. Kung si kamo mga maestro ani, walay katungod inyong estudyante nga magsulay sa inyo. Mag-examine sa inyo. That would be, si matawag din mo na nga, among estudyante nga, ma'am, pasar exam answer ni ma'am 10 times nga gisulay-sulayan pero gibuhat na sa Israel sa Ginoo. Walay mga estudyante nga nagsulay-sulay nga para sa Ma'am Brenda, ayaw gyud mo kuan ka Ma'am Brenda, makatilaw mo kang Ma'am Brenda, pero sa Ginoo ilang giana sayon-sayon lang suko kayo ang Ginoo sa Israel. Muna sa verse 23 unya, sa verse 22 niya, because all those men which have seen my glory and my miracles which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness and have tempted me now these 10 times and have not hearkened unto my voice. They hardened. Nga ang kaayo og pagahom sa Ginoo og ang mga milagro nakita nila, nakapagahi pagyud sinun sila sa Ginoo. When you are experiencing the goodness of God, be sure nga damol nga mo humok imong tuhod nga muluhod diha sa Ginoo, nga magpaubos sa Ginoo. Kini kay nahimo naman siyon silang mga arrogante. Muna nga sa verse 23 ingon niya, surely, kini yung word nga surely, mura, sama ni po atong thou shall surely die. Nga, surely they shall not see the land which I swear unto their fathers. Nga, neither shall any of them that provoke me see it. Wala yung nakakita niya ito. All of them for 40 years were in the wilderness ug hinay-hinay silang gipamatay sa Ginoo. Antod nga ang sunod nga kaliwatan, gipangulohan na ron ni Joshua ug ni Caleb ang ni. But in verse 24, tawon sa verse 24, numbers niya, but my servant Caleb, because notice this, he had another spirit with him. Sa billions ka mga tao ning gawas, kinilang ang lahig espiritu. At ang tanong, sa maning klase nga espiritu, nga nalahi man sila. Another spirit with him and hath followed me fully. Nya, him will I bring into the land where into he went and his seed shall proceed. Lagi nito, unsa nga klase ni nga spirit? Now, indan yung, murag, muna nga yung ako ang Bible, murag sigsad puzzle ni. Now, ang tubag na sa New Testament, 2 Timothy chapter 1. 2 Timothy chapter 1. Unsa nga klase ng espiritu ni? Amo ni nga espiritu. Sa 2 Timothy chapter 1 and in verse 7. Layo kayo no. Tuwa sa Genesis. Tuwa dito sa 5 books. Nag-ayos ko tantong another spirit. O saan nga another spirit? Na ang tubag na sa 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. Ngunya, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear. Ang mga millions ng mga Israelita, nangahadlok sila tanan nga musulod dito sa saad. Saad sa Ginoo. Niya, go in and possess it. Ingon sa Ginoo, dili, among motong kini niya. But God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Muna nga klase nga espiritu nga na kang kalib. Now notice what it means here. Tanama. Sa 1 John chapter 4 and in verse 18. Katong fear siya. This is the kind of spirit. John chapter 4 and in verse 18. Now, daghan sa inyo ha, daghan mga tao nga, dili good kasimba na. Dili. Why? Because they have another, dili paras kang kuan nga espiritu. Daghan. Pero niya sa John chapter 4 and in verse 18. Kaya nga, there is no fear in love. But perfect love casts out fear. Why? Because fear hath torment. Din niya, he that feareth is not made perfect in love. Noon sa nga fear. Muna nga klase, ang naa sa mga kadtong makauban ni Joshua nga nag-spy out. Unya, naghatag sila report. Unya, nanga-influensya. Nga ang tanong karoon, nangahadlok na, nga musulod sa saad sa Ginoo, mayutang saad. And in fact, because of their fear of entering in, ang naitabo karon gusto na ba ganin nilang batuon, patyon si Moses together with Caleb and Joshua. But this turned out. Fear. Now, think about you. Daghang mga tao nga, sabihin mo, siguro, I read a book. Dugay-dugay na to. By the way, I could recall din na kayo tigbasag libro. Pero kana to, sige kong basag mga libro. At kanang mga libro, pambasahon ko na kanan. And one of the book that I read, he said, niya, in heaven, there will be many Christians that we regret. Ila, nanaunta ang ilaha, padulong sila, because of fear, it was with him. Ugmoni ang mga nahitabo nga picture sa daghang kayong ng mga Israel na kagawas sa ilang pagkaulipon. And God did not only promise for redemption, but God promised them rest. Og pagsulod ganin nila sa Diyos sa Kanaan, there were battles. And that battles was fought, but it was fought by God, not by Joshua. And that fight is, doon ay fear gyapon to. Pero ang mayo, lahi ang espiritu sa mga tao sa Ginoo, just like Joshua and when they enter the land. Now, daghang mga Kristiyano nga magmahay gyud do. Ngunya sa book. Because what happened to Caleb and Joshua is a picture of church. That we are just like them, we redeemed by God. But most of them, almost all of them, suffered in the wilderness. And we are just like them, dili karon, that we are redeemed. Pero, as if we are in the wilderness. Why? Because he. Pero kung Caleb, he has that another spirit. Now, tanaw ka ron. In Joshua chapter 14. Joshua chapter 14. In Joshua chapter 14. Diretso na lang. In Joshua chapter 14 and in verse in the whole chapter, when Israel had now occupied the land, di bahin-bahin, ilan ang bahin-bahinon ang panalangin. Ug kang Joshua natoman ang saad sa Ginoo. That when they were in Egypt, they had no position. When they were in Egypt, they have no lands. They have no properties. But when they enter in, now they have properties and they are to divide it among themselves. As God's token to His faithfulness, to His promise. Now, tanaw sa verse 5. Verse 5. Unya, as the Lord commanded Moses, so the children of Israel did and they divided the land. Kini, ang magbahin-bahin ni Rikaron, kadtong mga anak niya, itong mga walay pagtuo sa Ginoo. Then the children of Judah came unto Joshua and, in Gilgal, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, said unto him, thou knowest the thing that the Lord said unto Moses, the man of God, concerning me, and thee in Kadesh Barnea. Karon ining irada ni, mautsinta na si Caleb ani. Yan ang ibahin-bahinon. Din nagpahinom doon mismo si Caleb. What transpired with them, with Joshua, in beside Kadesh Barnea? Then niya, verse 7 niya, 40 years old was I when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land. And I brought him word again as it was in my heart. Now notice this. Atong giliskutan itong espiritu, lahi nga espiritu ni Caleb. Nga katong nga espiritu, motoy nahimong distinguishing factor sa nga nahimong panalangin siya, nakasad ang Ginoo, nga panalanginan siya, o karon iyang iklim to nga panalangin. Kay iya man pong gisunod ang Ginoo. Lahi iyang espiritu. Dinungon niya sa verse 8, nevertheless, my brethren that went up with me made the heart of the people melt. Dinya, but I wholly follow the Lord my God. Now, sabot pa sabot, that is kind, the kind of spirit nga naa kang Caleb is his willingness and his determination to follow what God said. And what God said, dunay pakapin. That they are to enter in and they will be blessed of God. He wholly followed the Lord. And that kind of spirit that he wholly followed the Lord, dili to siya nahimong mababagan, bisan ang tanan, magdumili, nga musunod sa Ginoo. Lahi siya. Ang uban tanan, no, kasagaran sa tua, ang prinsipyo, majority, motoy roles, masunod. Kasagaran sa tua, sila manggani, padulong nito, kita po di ay. Si Caleb lahi ang espiritu. Kay kung tanan mo dili nga musulod, ang tanan mo upo sa Ginoo, ang tanan duwa na walay musulod sa Ginoo, si Caleb magpadayon nga masinundan sa Ginoo. Ug kana was a testimony when he was in the spy, in the land of spy, and with him made that report. He had another spirit nga magmasinundanon siya sa Ginoo. Ingani. King Saul was the first king of Israel. And King Saul was rose to power because of God. In effect, nakatilaw og panalangin si King Saul. But there was a time that King Saul leaped out God. Meaning to say, he abandoned God. Og ang rason niya, yang giabandon na ang Ginoo tungod kay nahadlok siya sa mayang mga tao. Ngabiyaan siya sa iyang mga tao. Magit ninyo ng prince, mga awan. Now, para masabtan ninyo, sometimes, there are times that we are being tested on the matter of our sincerity in the faith of God. Daghang mga parsko, daghang mga tao na kasagaran musunod sa Ginoo kay daghan man naga muadtuman tanan o ginaguyod siya naman. Ano kanang gaya-gaya po tumaya ba? Dili nga ang principle sa pag ang klase nga doon na espiritu sa Ginoo. Kay kanang gaya-gaya pag wala na mubiya na. Si Caleb dili doon na siya'y tenacity kung mag-in-English mo. Doon na siya'y kung ba, perseverance o tenacity that he will magpabilin siya even if others will not follow or will leave him. Og this kind, pamati mo mayo, og this kind of spirit, kung mong tanawon, mauni ang espiritu sa ni David. When Goliath challenged the Philistines at that time, no one wants to fight. They have no spirit to fight. Pero si David, lahi siya, wala gani siya training. Pero kung sulat so yun, this is common story. Pero ang favor sa Ginoo is because David had life just like Caleb had another spirit. He wanted and longed to follow God rather to be in the majority. Lahi siya. Og kinipod nga espiritu, mopod ni ang klase nga espiritu nga naakang Daniel. Si Daniel was already in power. He was opposed of everyone in the sayang kung kuan pa in the authority. Everyone. Gani gi-entrap si Daniel nga sa unsang pamaagi nga pwede siya nga patyon. And that is in prayer. But he had another spirit. Nagpabilin siya and God's favor just like kang David, just like kang Caleb and even kang Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego na ang pabor sa Ginoo ni adtong mga tao. Oh, gaya-gaya po to Maya. I know you. Ay mga tao nga doon lang sa Ginoo because there are some things that they think that they are benefited of. And when you take it all, then you will be tested that indeed he do not have that kind of spirit just like Caleb had. Masabdan ko ninyo. And that happened even every man that stand for God, kana actually lahi na sila ng espiritu. Usahay, dili nila na sila gusto, dili sila gusto anak, kay lahi ang espiritu. Pero yung espiritu is always in favor din sa Ginoo. Tanawan. Balik. Numbers chapter 14. Ano sa verse 24? Nya, but my servant Caleb, nya, because he had another spirit with him. That kind of spirit that he do not learn to fear anything and anyone. His fear is in the Lord. And ingon niya sa 1 Timothy chapter 1, 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 niya, he had this kind of mind. He had a sound mind. Which means that compared to these people that flip up God, they have polluted kind of thinking. Why? Klaro ilang huna-huna. Si Caleb, doon ay guwapong huna-huna. Bisag siya lang sa ano yun ang ani. Usay kung kita lang sa gabaro. Ang tanaw sa uban ko lang, ni, huwag yun, bugok yun niya tao. Now, si David, or si Caleb, murag bugok ni siya. Pero sa Ginoo, he was so much in favor. So tanaw ron sa verse 25 niya. Now the Amalekites and the Canaanites, now ingani, when I'm speaking about this, I want you to build a kind of spirit just like Caleb. Baguhan ng imuang espiritu. Ampuan ni Buna. Liguna. Ngambot na kong pasabot, awato na to ni nga tao. Ingani ng mga tao nga ang pabor sa Ginoo naniini. Dili kay nagakondemn ni. Gusto nako na makita nato ni nga klase nga espiritu para kini ang atong awaton. Kay na diri ang pabor sa Ginoo niini nga klase nga tao. Then unya verse 25. Now the Amalekites and the Canaanites dwell in the valley na tomorrow turn you and get you into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. And the Lord speak unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, nya, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation? Now he's speaking about those majority that goes against Caleb or goes against God or had left out God. And their kind of evidence of their despising God is that they do not want to enter Canaan, God's promised land. Why? Because of fear. And their fear is that they see the people inside Canaan as giants. And they consider themselves as grasshopper. To that, in effect, ang ilang ginatanaw, ang giant o ilang kagwalingon, nawala sa passing ang Ginoo. So karon yun na, kung makigaway ta, patay kita. O dili man na mo. Kay later on, si Joshua, sila yung musulot siya, nakigaway siya, pero ang nakigaway para sila ang Ginoo. na kwan sila ba? Morning, ang tawag sa Ginoo ni ining matuhana di that had leaped out God in their life because of the giants are people with evil heart. They become evil because they lost faith in God, and that is unbelief. Masundan ko ninyo? Kurbano sa ako kung mag-English ko, kaya ba hindi masundan? Labi na ni sila lang. Sundan ko ni Mario. Masundan ko ninyo? Natanawa sa verse 27. How long shall I bear with this evil congregation? Kanang evil congregation kana kadtutong mga kauban ni Caleb nganing gawas sa kana sa Egypt. Mga Israel ni. Pero sa diyang nana sila sa gawas nun sila, nana sa padulong na sila sa Kanaan na nag-spy out man sila, nag-spy sila. Ang hangi sa nga, atutang tanawon. Siniguro ba? Siniguro? Sigurista? Siniguro? Kaya nang tanawang sa dito ang Kanaan kung maayod. Pag adto nila sa Kanaan, maayog yun. Tua ang niya, the land flowing with milk and honey, nagdala pa yun sila, example. Pero ang problema, doon ay mga higanti, na ay gira, na ay away. Ang gusto nila, mukuha itong grapes, pero way away, way gira, way pasingot. Amo man nagsagara ng itong gusto. Kung na ay pasingot, dili. Muna kung magtanaw mo, magpakaon tayo rin, puno ang simbahan. Magpatrabaho ka, doon, gamay ra. Mugyod niya ang principle, gyod ni mo. Pero ang concept, now, remember that this kind of character or attitude of people in the eyes of God, evil. Evil. Tanong sa verse 27, balik. Niya, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation which murmur against me? Murmur against me niya, I have heard the murmurings of the children of Israel which the murmur against me. Di niya, see unto them as a result. Niya, sorti sila. As truly as I live, saith the Lord, as ye have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you. Muna ang recompense nga gihatag sa Ginoo nining evil congregation that are murmurers. They are complainers. Unya, abin mo sila yung murmuring? Unya, kanunay nga, basta na sila Kristiyan, muana sila ng Moses. May, kanong ipagawas pa mo ang God binay mo Moses sa Egypt? Nga dito, gwapo man among kaon. Nito. Mas mayo nga dito may mamatay kaysa diri sa wilderness. Every time nga, mas, bukan mo na kanunay. Ang gibuhat sa Ginoo, gusto day mo nga mamatay sa wilderness. May Lord, gipatay sila sa Ginoo sa wilderness. Nigilisog-lisog sila. Nga ni, bantayan ninyo ni kay, kanunay ba mo gamarman? Sige lang magsultig lisod. Sige lang maglisod. Sige lang magpait. Murag ba yung anak? Murag walay. Ang yung tanaw sa inyong kinibot, puros Kristanan. Ang but pasibot nga wag yung ipikto, way ayo ang inyong Ginoo. Then you said, God is love. If God is love, then say some complimentary about the word love of God to you. Ang mga tao nga muna. Pero kung sa ka pait, lisod kayo. Kung sa ka pait, hapit na mamatay. Kung sa ka lisod yun kayo. Pero tabangin, wag yung appreciation nga kayo sa Ginoo siyang kinabuhi. So muna ingon niya sa verse 28 niya, say unto them, as truly as I live, saith the Lord, as ye have spoken to my ears, maupo na akong gumawaton sa inyo. In effect, God is telling, what you say and what you think, you become. What you say and what you think, you become. Kuhaan ang atlasing ang pangunahuna. Kasagaran sa mga tao, anak yun, anak. Nadili na angay sa Kristo. Na may musultig ni Isod, tanan good, tao ng Isod, pero wala, bayat na pasagli sa Ginoo. Wala eh. Na yung mga salt ka na ito, para sa kuha. Kaya ganit itong when I surrendered my profession and go to the ministry, tagang nag-sorting at di ko makapahuman o giskwila. Para sa sa inyo, di maglisog man tagpahuman. Nangahuman inyong mga anak o giskwila man lagi. Nakatrabaho man lagi. Pero ang di mayo, walay ayo kanunay ang Ginoo sa inyo. Sige lang mag-complain, complain, mer, muna. Hantod ang generation na generation. Walay appreciation sa Ginoo. Book of Psalms, si David ang sulat ito. Ang Book of Psalms is full of appreciation. Diyan matumog langit. Diyan matumog langit. Kano matumog langit nga murag di man mayo ang yung Ginoo din sa yuta. Pasailong ako doon. Pero murag yung anak ba? Di ba? Murag yung anak eh. Sige lang mag-complete. Sige lang mag-murmur. Sige mo kon. Mga, so as a result, maglisod-lisod, boxer na sila mayo, boxer na ang ginora mo, but seek ye first the kingdom of God, give unto you a mission, mawa yun ang principle sa purong sa akin. Nga pa nito yung daghang mga Kristohan, kung yan mo, baguhan yung kinahuna. Caleb is a man with another spirit. Nagkapagulbol sila tanan, pero siya walay bagulbol. Ang tanawa, Exodus chapter 16 and in verse 3. Now, every time that I give a message, do not consider this as mga kwan, murag negative, pero actually, gusto na ako baguhon, i-change ba akong kwan? Or go with me. Do not allow yourself to be pessimistic all the day of your life until you are under 6 feet below the ground. Ako na muna lang pessimistic. Kung wala, pang lipstick mo. Kaya na ay TIC. Don't be a negative thinker kind of a person. Kay hopeless kanunay ang narinig mo. Be a man of positive thinking because God is on your side. Tinawa ro good. Tinawa niyong kinabuhi karon. Di ba ka na ito, wala mo yung mga trabaho, dili mo nag-aukan, sige mo, ka na ito, wala mo yung trabaho, puno, kagulba, puro mga bagulbol. Karun, napwisto malay ka, undangin na yung mong pagbagulbol. Change your kind or mentality. Be appreciative to God. Be a man of another spirit. While others, everyone of your family, maybe all are complainer, force, fight. Ingunin mo ako, maayo ang Ginoo sa mo ba? Lahi ni, lahi ko akong Ginoo. Maayo ang Ginoo. Kaya ka, when was God be glorified to you? Kung yung anak ka nga klase nga mentality. Para sa kanaman niya itong mga amiga, oh. May ngani-ani ala tira, mandisigon sila nga nag-aapan sa iyo. Then I would like to repeat, if you are a fan of complainer and you are full of fear, pessimistic kind of person, that means that God is not dealing with you. It means that it, if God had ang imong pagkakasalan wa ipikto niya din sa imo. So as a result, ano mo man kag langit? Kung unsa imong kon ito nga ang Dios nga buhi ka dili man maayo lagi sa imo. Ano mo to ka dito? Dili maayo. It must be you must have to experience the goodness of God in heaven while you are still alive here, so that you have reason to rejoice. Exodus chapter 16. I hope ako abi ninyo adi lang ko nagakon nga nagud ko madungog nga mga kwan-kwan niyo kay kinakong asawa himanta mo kon puni pero ako abang ino ako di lang ko nagawlat lang man pugos nga munghung sa kuha na maghunghung buho hunghung ay mo kaulo hunghung rayon dugang gamay kog tulog luha di bagod masuyo panjud ko nimo. Masuyo panjur ko niyo. Kailang panjur. Naman, because my God is good. Wa mo na kabantay nga magwali ko din nga walay complaining about God. Wa mo kabantay din nga ubang simbahan at mo nang mabili, anang mabili ka na ito. Kwarta halos tanan ginaiskutan. Dari wala ako nag-iskut-iskut o kwarta ay. Na yung mga simbahan, murag kanunay mala, sige, lagiskot o kwarta, sige, lagkwano, upiring, upiring, dili wala baya. Sortira, pwede na ba, bra? Na magwali ko? Wala eh. Ano man, dili na ako, dili, abot lang, dili, I don't want you to feel na mura matagkanong empty ta. Dili, God is very good, muna kanunay, gasulti ko nga, sufficiente ang ginawa. As a result, wala ko naganahan na sa inyo nagapang mga warbang nag-ana-ana. Wala. Because my God is great. Be a man of another spirit. Kaya ganiya, doon ako ika-istorya din. Tonto, nag-istoryahan na yun. Doon nakita na ako nga ako. A human is one you. Tell me. Caleb was a man, was a kind of man of a kind. Millions of people. Only Caleb was mentioned that he had another spirit. Talagsa on the yun. Pero kung tanaw ni mo ang great men of God, God that was so blessed, morning spirit, nga na sila, si Job. Job had another kind of spirit. Even God had taken everything kang Job. Job said, God take it, God give it, God take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And he never say anything. Walay murmur, walay good, walay complain. Kita gamay, now don't, kwa ang imong manner to be a murmurer. Complaining. Muna akong ginasalamat sa akong partner. Kuning itanggal siya. Naidagkang, dahil mga pastor nga complainer, murmurer. Makita ni muna. Dili ko nagakuan ba? Pero muimanit na dapat. Another spirit. Exodus chapter 16. Hadama sa verse 2 o sa verse 3. Unya, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. Murmured. Now, take note that every time that they murmured, they complained to Moses, particularly to Moses, is actually complaining unto God. Kay Moses is only acting upon the will of God. Everything that Moses do for this million of people is because it was God's ordering him to do. So therefore, every time that they complain and murmur, it was not to Moses, but it was before God. So ingon niya, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. And the children of Israel said unto them, would to God we had died in the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt when we sat by the flesh pots, and when we did eat bread to the full, for For ye have brought us forth into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Now, kung imong tanawon diri, ang gina-exhort every time that the complain, murmur against God, ang ilang gina-exhort, katong life nila in their slavery. And Egypt is a picture of the world that is being used to enslave them. Ilang gina-exhort to? Wa nila ma-appreciate ang ilang gatag sa Ginoo nga pagkagawas nun, gikan sa pagkaulipon, and in fact, actually, and in truth, when a person is murmuring, that person is out of his mind. Because, first of all, kung tanawin nimo sa Exodus chapter 3. In Exodus chapter 3, tanawa sa verse 6. Verse 7 na lang. Tanawa. Exodus chapter 3 and in verse 7. Now, this is the reason why God came to rescue them. This is the reason why God came to deliver them. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmaster, for I know their sorrows. Usahay, ang ilang ginatanaw, nakalimot sila, na perting paita di ay, ang ilang ginatanaw karon sa dirang nagawas naman sila, na himuon na po nilang islib ang Ginoo. Nga every time na kuan isi, wala na ipasingot na po ba? Pero sa islibir siya, magpasingot sila kung karusa siya pagkaon, mautoy pagkaon nila. Pero sa dayang nahimo na silang gawas noon, ang di mayo kay ang Ginoo na may ilang ulipo noon. Mura na mag, Lord, may tinapay. Lord, may tubig. Sir, mura something is wrong. Nakita niyo na? Knowing ani, when they were slave, they have no freedom. But when they were redeemed of God, they have freedom. They could now make a choice to serve God or not to serve God. Umagtarong na silang Diyan. Dili sila gina-slave sa ginuba. Para sa punsa to, di man ka gina-puan sila. Even you are saved. Dear God. God did not take away your free will. But rather, God wants you to serve Him with all your will and with all your heart. Kinikaid lahit naman. Ngailan namang basulon. Abikog kung makristuhano na ta. Kuan naman, muraga ulan-ulan na, di na kahit mo. Muna daghang mentality sa uban. Dili, eh. You have to exercise your faith. You have even to work. But the good thing is, God now become your partner. As just like in David, I will fight for you. Just like for Joshua, I will fight for you. God now is in your favor. Muna ang difference. So, nanawa sa verse 3, Exodus chapter 16, verse 3. Ayok nga makita niyo. And the children of Israel said unto them, would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the fleshy pots, and when we did eat bread to the full. For ye have brought us forth in the wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Then said the Lord to Moses, behold, I will rain bread from heaven for you, and the people shall go out and gather a certain rate every day, that I may prove them whether they will walk in my law or not. Caleb the man with another spirit. Sometimes God put us into a place of testing and sometimes in a place of decision. Usahay mo abot ta diha ba? Pero usahay kung mag-make up, mag-buhat ang decision just like po ning aning mga Israel, that most of their decision was influence of people that do not have faith in God. Katong 12 spies, napulo niya ito, walay pagtuo sa Ginoo. O kining napulo, mo'y gituuhan sa milyon ka mga tao. Kaya ang kanilang ginatanaw, katong gikadlukan, nga kaugmaon kaysa tong saad sa Ginoo nga ang Ginoo di mo biya sila. Sometimes say you are being put into that place of decision. I hope nga kini mahimo nimong tanaw. Caleb, a man with another spirit. Then David was a man with another spirit. Daniel was a man with another spirit. Peter was a man with another spirit. Paul was a man with another spirit. Put your name there. You have another spirit. Why? Because the spirit that is in you do not have you to make fear, but rather, tanawa, Romans chapter 8, then we will close. Romans chapter 8, and in verse 15 to verse 16. Ngunya, for ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear. Now that is freedom. Ngunya, for we have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear. Naana ka din ang dapita. Gibutang na ka sa Ginoo. Kung tinuod ka, nag-aampo ka, sa pagipangayo sa Ginoo, og nabutang ka na din. Noon niya, anong pagto na mampod ka sa kabala ka? Gibutang naman ka, kadiyan sa Ginoo. So yun niya, for ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Now you see, ang buot pasubot na ni, kanadto, God is not our Father. We don't have relation with God. Now if God is your Father, labi na karon kay kamong mga Father, you know what it means to be Father. You will always provide. You will supply the need. That is your duty. And that is much more for God. So now, what? Ayaw na mo anong fear. Then, verse 16. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. Do you understand what it means to be children of God? Now you have your children. Did you came to the point na pagipasagdan ni mo ang imong anak na gigutma-gutman? Did you came to a point na wani mo gisupply ang need sa imong mga anak? Motingon niya, if you as a man, as a father, give good gifts to your son, how much more your father which is in heaven? My challenge is, be a man with another spirit. Ayaw gaya-gaya putumaya. Let us all stand up and let us pray. Our most gracious and loving Father, Lord, salamat sa mga painumdom niya sa mong pulong. Help us to understand that that kind of spirit is spirit that is anchored in faith, in the faith of God. That is not the spirit of fear, but the spirit of faith in God. That God made a promise that said, I will not leave thee nor forsake thee. I will be with thee. So be it, Lord, help us. That in every circumstance sa mong kinabuhi, let it not be nga parehas mi sa uban. Full of murmurer, full of complaining, full of insecurity, as if God do not deal with them. Let it not be to us because we are your children. And as a father, you are obliged and to be here obliged. And your duty is to be the provider, just like what David said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Bless as you've been blessing the message. Father, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Be a kind of another spirit. Baguha ang inyo ang mga Panginoon. Let God be exalted in your life. Let God be glorified in your life. Allow people to see the goodness of your Father, of your God, that God is always your provider.
Living for Jesus, a life that is true, striving to please Him in all that I do. Yielding allegiance, broad-hearted and free. This is the pathway Oh, blessing for me. Oh, Jesus, Lord and Savior, I give myself to thee. For thou in thine atonement didst give thyself for me. I owe no other master. My heart shall be thy throne. My life I give his fall to thee. Oh, Christ, for thee I live it for Jesus, who died in my place, bearing on Calvary my sin and disgrace. Such love constrains me to answer his call, follow his leading, and give him my all. Oh, Jesus, Lord and Savior, I give myself to thee. For thou in thy atonement didst give thyself for me. I owe no other master. My heart shall be thy throne. My life I give him for to thee. For thee, living for Jesus, through earth's little while, my dearest treasure, the light of his smile, seeking the lost one, he died to redeem. Ringing the refuge to find rest in him. Oh, Jesus, Lord, I say, I give myself to for thou in thy atonement didst give thyself for me. I owe no other master. My heart shall be thy throne. My life I
gusto na ko ibilin siya nung muna-una niya. Make some good testimony of God to your life. Let others see that God is good to you. That God is, you are being benefited of God. Ayaw itong, sige ba yung kagkaon? Naman kay pilit, kumplito man. So, that would be a reason na, musta ka maayagod ang Ginoon sa ko. Ang Ginoong provided yun. Dili nga, kumusta ka? Perting paita yun yung kinabuhi. Ang saan naman niya itong ekonomiya? Uy, mga take away that in your mouth. Kwa kaling. Exhort God. Let's pray. Sui! Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, Lord, salamat sa manindot na panimbahon for the whole day. Thank you, Father, for speaking to us through thy word, a word of encouragement, a word of assurance that we are being born again and God now become our Father because we become the children of God by faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. We have God, the creator of all things, the provider of all things, our protector. God is so much sufficient. He is able to do anything and everything. And indeed, we experience God's goodness among. So help us, Lord, to testify your kindness, love, goodness to us. Bless us, we've been blessing you. And bless now your people, Lord, as we again entered another lunes hantod sabado nga pagkinabuhi na ibunan diha kanimo kay kami malino umon kanon ay masinaligon that you will provide everything that we need. Lord, salamat sa mensahe and salamat sa mga katawhan. Tabangi nga dunay mga nakuto na mga pagtulunan na magamit na mo sa mong pagkinabuhi uban kanimo. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.